I am going to navigate through the cancer.org website to show people in the Houston area how to find cervical cancer resource information, how to find the information, access the information, and also put it into something practical that someone can access from home. If they have questions about, what do I do to find treatment? What is the treatment like? What are the side effects? And where can I go for treatment? So those types of questions I'm hoping to answer in this screencast. So as I'm starting out, I'm already on the cancer.org website through the American Cancer Society. Once you go to the home page, you'll see these tabs up on the top. If you click on the first one, Cancer A through Z, just scroll down to the letter C and find cervical cancer, and then that's where we can begin with all of the information or accessing the information. Again, all of this information is in Spanish and English. There are other languages that you can access as well. But for now, we're going to stick to English. So once we're on here, so again, I'm just going to direct you to where the information is. We're not going to go through all of it because some of it is very detailed. I'm just going to show you how to access the information so that you can look into the specific type of stage that you may be at, or maybe you just have a question as far as, what does this treatment look like, or I'm at this stage, what does treatment look like for that stage? So everyone may be everyone may have different questions. So that's why we won't go through it. Also, because the screencast is only 15 minutes long. So we'll go to so on the first page, the question is, can cervical cancer be found early? And it'll go through all of the different information here. Essentially, what they're telling you is to get regular pap smears, speak to your doctor if you're noticing anything unusual, and it'll take you through that information. So that's, and then at the bottom also it'll go through different type accessing different types of information about cervical cancer, causes, risk factors, prevention, early detection, diagnosis, staging, treatment, and after treatment. And so that's the first page. And then the second page will go through signs and symptoms of cervical cancer. Then they'll go through testing for cervical cancer. The fourth page discusses cervical cancer stages. And then on the fifth page, it'll talk about survival rates for cervical cancer by stage. And then last but not least, it will go through what should you ask your doctor about cervical cancer. And then it'll have different questions. What type of cervical cancer do I have? Has my cancer spread outside of the cervix? Can the stage of my cancer be determined, and what does that mean? It'll go through various types of questions that you can ask your doctors, your providers, your gynecologists, oncologists, so that you can decide on a plan that is right for you, a treatment that is right for you. So it'll take you through during treatment, after treatment. So it'll give you some guiding questions. And there's also, so we'll go through treatment, treating cervical cancer. It'll also give you general treatment information. If you want to go through stages of cervical cancer, we'll look at that as well. And this will just tell you who consists of your team, which is your gynecologist, your gynecologic oncologist, your radiation oncologist and medical oncologist, as well as the various types of nurse practitioners, nurses, psychologists, social workers, community health workers, health professionals. They are all part of your team, so that you can decide what is right for you. And the types of treatment, depending on what stages you're at, may or may not include surgery, radiation therapy, chemotherapy, and targeted therapy. Again, it all depends on what stage you're looking at and the plan that's right for you. And then it also discusses clinical trials. It'll also talk about complementary and alternative methods. It will, and there is also a page for programs and services that include rides to treatment, lodging, support groups, and more. And we'll discuss that at the end. And that's what this page will talk about. And then it'll also, so this is the page where it discusses cervical cancer stages. And it'll explain the staging system. The Internal Federation of Gynecology and Obstetrics staging system is used most often for cancers of the female reproductive organs, including cervical cancer. Staging is based mainly on the results of the doctor's physical exam and a few other tests that are done in some cases, such as cystoscopy and proctoscopy. This is not based on what is found during surgery. So it'll talk about that. It will also explain the American Joint Committee on Cancer, TNM staging system classifies cancer on the basis of three factors: the extent of the main tumor, whether the cancer has spread to nearby lymph nodes, whether the cancer has metastasized or has spread to distant parts of the body. And so it'll give you an explanation of what tumor extent is, and the various stages, and also lymph node spread, and what these abbreviations mean, the distance spread, and what those abbreviations mean, stage grouping and FIGO stages. And it'll take you all the way to stage four. And then for treatment, and so here are treatment options for cervical cancer by stage. The stage of a cervical cancer is the most important factor in choosing treatment, but other factors can also affect your treatment options, including the exact location of the cancer within the cervix, the type of cancer, your age and overall health, and whether you want to have children. Stage zero, it'll take you through stage zero and the treatment options for these stages. And it'll go through all of the different stages and your treatment options. Again, these may vary. And in the end, they'll go through recurrent cervical cancer. Cervical cancer in pregnancy. And it'll end there. Here. And it will also take you to finding support programs and services in your area, and you can search for programs in your area. There's patient lodging information, road to recovery or rides to treatment, breast cancer, hair loss and mastectomy products, look good, feel better information. Programs and service videos online, communities and support. When I went through this for the Houston area, I think I found better information, and I'll show you these other sites. But this is at AuntBertha.com, and once you're there, you can search for programs and services by putting in your zip code. And when I put in I put in a 77009 zip code because that's central to Houston, the Houston area. And so when I pulled that up for cervical cancer, I found the Women's Cancer Foundation, and I also found Medicaid for breast and cervical cancer by the Texas Department of Health, Texas Department of State Health Services. And so once here, this took me to the website, and I'll give you a description. This took me to their website, and I'm going to see if I can pull it up. Yeah, so let's take you to your website, and I've already pulled it up here. And once it took me to the Healthy Texas Women website, you can apply for insurance here if you don't have insurance. And once here, you can find a clinic that takes the Healthy Texas Women program. I'm sorry, it's a program, not an insurance. So the Healthy Texas Women program is accepted at 751 clinics within 10 miles of the 77009 area. And here is a map of all of those clinics. There's just about a clinic in every part of our inside the loop. And so that you may be able to find treatment at one of these clinics. I would apply for the program, the healthcare program first, and then call the individual clinics or the clinic that is close to you and see if they accept the Healthy Texas Women program. And if they do, then you can make an appointment and set up your pap smear or your well woman's exam. Make an appointment for a well woman's exam, and then you can also get your pap smear done and start from there. So your first starting point is your pap smear, and then based on whether or not that is an abnormal pap, you can discuss with your gynecologist what is the right plan for you. And then once you get if that is something that you're going to that you're looking at, then the questions may come in handy for you as far as what should you ask your doctor about cervical cancer. So these questions may be helpful, as well as what does the treatment look like, what stage are you at, and that's where all of these pages will come in handy. Again, cancer.org if you need to find some services, auntbertha.com, and for the women's healthytexaswomen.org to apply for the program and find a clinic near you. I hope this was helpful, and thank you for visiting.